Hey, it's Harry, and today we're going to look at how to set up an EVO 4 audio interface with an iOS device. Whether you're looking to record some music, or create a mobile podcast, or even up your audio quality on live streaming apps such as Facebook or Instagram Live. Firstly, it's worth mentioning that when you register EVO 4, you get access to a bunch of free software and plugins, which includes Cubasis LE, which is an iOS recording platform, meaning you have everything you need to get your mobile production up and running straight out of the box. If you have one of the newer iPad Pros which use USB-C connectors, then you can go ahead and just plug a USB-C to C cable straight from that to EVO 4 and get going straight away. If you have an older iPad or an iPhone which uses a Lightning connector, then these on their own won't be able to power EVO 4, so you'll need a few extra bits. Firstly, you'll need a powered USB hub, and these can be powered from a wall socket or you can attach an appropriate battery pack to them. And secondly, you'll need a camera adapter kit which converts USB-A to Lightning to plug into your iOS device. To connect it all together, firstly, plug EVO 4 into one of the ports on the USB hub. Then plug the USB cable of the USB hub into the camera adapter kit. And finally, connect the camera adapter kit to your iOS device. You're also able to charge the iOS device while you're using it to make sure you don't run out of battery while you're in the middle of something by plugging a USB charging cable between the USB hub and the Lightning port on the camera connector kit. At this point, you can also plug in any compatible USB devices, such as keyboards or controllers, into the USB hub and they should connect to your iOS device. So now EVO 4 has power from the USB hub and it's also connected to the iOS device through the hub and the camera adapter kit. And as soon as the iOS device detects it, it will automatically switch across the inputs and outputs to use EVO 4. Some apps will give you more control than others when it comes to the audio settings. So for example, if you want to use EVO 4 with something like Facebook or Instagram Live, you can't actually go in and edit any of the audio settings. You just have to set it up as shown here and start streaming. But if you're using audio recording packages like Cubasis or GarageBand, then you'll have a lot more control over the different audio settings, such as sample rate, buffer size, and the various inputs that you're wanting to use at any one time. So let's take a look at how to get a session set up in Cubasis. So first we open the app, and it'll automatically open up a demo project. So to create a new project, we go to the top left icon here, and then we click New Project. And then you can give it a name if you'd like. So here we have an empty project, and just to make sure that EVO 4 is connected as we expect, we go into settings, and then to audio, and then we can see that EVO 4 is connected in the hardware latency area. Now we just want to create an audio track, so we click add down the bottom here, and add audio. So now we've created a track and we just need to make sure that it's using the right input. So right now I have an SM7B here connected to input one. So if we click the routing tab here, we can check that mono input number one is selected. And if we want to channel two, we just click the number one there, switch it across to number two. But we'll keep it to number one for now. So now we're ready to record, but first we want to make sure that we can hear everything that's happening in our headphones. You are able to monitor your inputs through Cubasis here itself by pressing this little speaker icon. When that's lit up blue, it means that you'll be able to hear your inputs in your headphones or speakers, but this can potentially introduce some latency or a delay. So if you don't want to do that, you can still use the monitor mix button and all the monitoring features on EVO 4 itself. The last thing to check is that the track is record enabled, which is this button here. So we just got to make sure that that is set to red. And now we're ready to record. So we hit the record button and we're away. This is a test of recording using EVO 4 on Cubasis on iPhone. And that's it. We've now got audio recorded through EVO 4 onto our iOS device. If you found this video useful, then please give it a like. And if you have any other questions about setting up iOS devices with EVO 4, then please leave a comment or get in touch with our support team. And don't forget to subscribe to keep up to date with EVO-related news and video content.